Hey everybody, I'm Ethan James with the Honest Carpenter YouTube channel. In this video, I'm teaming up with FlexScreen to offer you some tips and tricks on how to best measure for your FlexScreen products. I know that many homeowners can feel intimidated when it comes to pulling measurements for their FlexScreens. There's a little bit of math involved and not everybody's really comfortable with using a tape measure, but I'm gonna show you a couple methods that will not only make finding those measurements easier, it'll also give you a way to test the fit of your FlexScreens before they show up. So let's get going. The most important tip in measuring for your FlexScreens is determining whether you do have window screen tracks or do not have window screen tracks. Most newer windows come with window screen tracks. It's a plastic channel that runs around the perimeter of the window beyond the sash. Some windows also have L-shaped flanges, like this. But many older windows, especially wooden windows, did not come with tracks. The jambs in the windowsill will have a flush surface. The measuring process is different for these two types of windows. So let's start with windows that do have window screen tracks. The first step is to make sure that FlexScreens will fit your screen tracks. FlexScreens have a certain thickness to them, so the track needs to be able to accommodate this edge. FlexScreens need 5/16 of an inch of clearance inside the track, but 5/16 is difficult to measure with the tape. So an easier way to tell if you have enough clearance is to use a mock-up. A mock-up is just a physical model that lets you visualize and test a measurement. In this case, we can use American quarters. A quarter is about 1/16 of an inch thick, so 5 quarters stacked up together equals about 5/16. If you can slot 5 US quarters into your window screen track, FlexScreens will fit in your track system. If 5 quarters don't fit, you'll have to use our method for measuring windows without screen tracks. We'll get to that in a moment. But for now, let's assume that your window screen tracks have enough proper clearance. You'll have to determine the size of each FlexScreen for each window opening. There's an official measuring guide on the FlexScreen website, and the methods there certainly work. But you can also simplify the process by using another mock-up. I like to use pieces of something stiff, but easy to cut. So my go-to material is fresh cardboard. But don't use an old crumpled box. Make sure the cardboard is rigid and undamaged. Buy a large box at Home Depot if need be. Now, cut 2 narrow pieces that are smaller than your window width, and make sure that the ends are square. You can use the corner of a magazine to check this. Set the pieces down in the screen track or behind the window screen flange and slide them to each side until they butt against the inner walls of the screen track. Once they're tight in that position, back them off just a little bit. Then, tape the 2 pieces together where they overlap using painter's tape or duct tape. Now, slide the conjoined cardboard pieces side to side again. You should have a little bit of play here, but not so much that the cardboard falls out if it's pulled to one side. You want it to jostle a bit, but stay in place. Here, you've got a perfectly good cardboard mock-up of your screen width. Just lay it down, pull your tape from one edge of the cardboard and measure to the other. That's the width measurement you'll put in for your window order. Easy as that. And this works just the same way for the height measurement too. You may need slightly longer pieces of cardboard to do this, but the theory is exactly the same. Take 2 pieces, slide them tight into the track opening, back them off, tape them, and then remove and measure. I really like this approach because when you're done with the window, you can just take your mock-up, move it to the next window over, and see if it fits there. Windows tend to be quite standard, and you can easily round up all the measurements you need for your house in just a fraction of the time. And whatever your pooled measurements are, those are the numbers that you're going to enter into the ordering form on the FlexScreen website. So that's how to measure for windows with window screen tracks. But, as I said before, not all windows have window screen tracks. Or they have window screen tracks that won't fit a FlexScreen. If this is the case for your windows, you'll have to use a slightly different method. For windows without acceptable tracks, you'll need to use these little rubber bumpers that FlexScreen provides. They adhere to the edge of the FlexScreen frame with self-adhesive backs. The little bumpers provide compression so that FlexScreens can hold themselves in place by tension. For this reason, you'll have to make your measurements a little tighter. How tight? In the end, you want to find your total available space between jams and take off just 1/16 or at most 1/8 of an inch. That's all the room these little bumpers require to create compression. If you make your FlexScreens smaller than that, they might lack compression and fall out. Also, be sure to test your fit at the bottom, middle, and top of the window. You want to make sure that there aren't any narrow sections of the window. If there are, then you want to base all of your measurements on the narrowest section of the window. This will make sure that your FlexScreens aren't too tight in those spots when they arrive. And again, you can do this exact same process for the height measurement as well. But if your span in this direction is very long, your windows are tall, you might want to consider using wooden dowels instead of cardboard. They're very rigid and work better for longer measurements. You can use 2 pieces in a pair to do the exact same thing you're doing with cardboard. And dowels tend to only be $1 to $2 at Lowe's or Home Depot, so they're very affordable. And if your window screens have tracks but they're not wide enough for flex screens, you can use this exact same method. You just want to measure the distance between the track edges. Don't slide the cardboard into the screen tracks at all because the flex screens won't fit in there. They'll have to be held between the track edges with the little bumpers and tension. When your flex screens show up, work them into the window openings and be sure that they have a little wiggle room that you want, but not so much that they fall out when you slide them around. And if you have trackless windows, put the little bumpers on the edges and test them to be sure that they fit with decent tension, but not enough to sag the screen mesh. Those are your best sizing guidelines. That's it. That's how you use cardboard mock-ups or wooden dowels to help find your flex screen measurements. I hope this video was helpful. If you have any other questions, please feel free to call or write or reach out to the flex screen staff. They're very attentive people. As for me, I'm Ethan James with the Honest Carpenter Channel. Thanks for watching and enjoy your flex screens.